Good evening, student. Today I will discuss about effect of temperature on resistance or resistivity. Okay. So, first of all, I will discuss about resistance. Resistance means it is the net opposition offered by a conductor or material which opposes the current where the current which is passed through that material. Here, in other way, it is the property of material which obstructs the electric current where the current passes through that material. Here, or resistivity, it is the nature of the material. Which type of material we have used so that the resistivity depends upon that material. Okay, so here I will discuss about effect of temperature on resistance or resistivity. Already you know that resistance, which is given by R equal to rho L by A, or R equal to M by N A square tau into L by A, where rho, which is given by M divided by N A square tau. Here, in that thing, M can be represented as mass of electron, N can be represented as number of electron per unit volume, A square, which is represented as E, charge of electron, E, which is represented as charge of electron, tau can be represented as relaxation time, L can be represented as length of the conductor, A can be represented as area of cross section. Here, so this is the overall view of resistance and resistivity. Okay, please note it. Now I will erase that one. Now I'll start with effect of temperature on resistance or resistivity. If we increase the temperature, then what will be the resistance and resistivity? Now I will discuss this one. Okay. Here, if we increase the temperature, in conductor, then in that given formula, that means T becomes increases, so that relaxation time becomes decreases. Why relaxation time becomes decreases? If you assume this is a conductor Inside the conductor, there are many number of electrons are present. That behaves as a free electrons. At a particular given temperature, the number of free electrons, they moves in zigzag motion and they collide with each other in a certain time. That certain average time represent as relaxation time. Clear? After increasing the temperature, then the free electron acquires some energy and they moves in zigzag motion with high velocity and they collide with each other frequently in a less time. Clear? So that their relaxation time becomes decreases. Clear? If you increase the temperature, then relaxation time becomes decreases. Due to decrease in temperature, decrease in sorry, relaxation time, in that formula, R and relaxation time both are reciprocal to each other. That's why there is a decrease in relaxation time, increase of resistance. So R becomes increases. That means resistance becomes increases. If you increase the resistance, that means relaxation time becomes decreases. In that same manner, resistivity of that material becomes decreases. Sorry, increases. Because resistivity and relaxation time becomes both are inversely proportional to each other. That's why relaxation time becomes decreases. In other way, resistivity of that material becomes increases. It is the one type of factor. Other factor of that given material, if you increase the temperature again, that is the second factor, then the free electron inside the conductor becomes increases. Why? Because inside the conductor there are many numbers of atoms are there, and there that atom whose outermost orbit contain valency electrons are present. In that outermost orbit, valency electrons are present. Okay, when they observe some energy by the outside, that electron observing energy, they becomes ionized. Due to ionization, electron becomes released or ionized. If you increase the temperature, electrons are ionized. So that the number of electron per unit volume becomes increases. Jeti puriyanro electron thila, ebe kon hila bodhila. Purpuru free electron thila, conductor bhitare. Ebe kon hila, again increase kar dila ame temperature ko. Setabele kon hila, number of free electron bodhila. Ore volume. Clear? So number of free electron per unit volume becomes increases. For that given formula, if we increase the number of electron per unit volume, then what will happen? Resistance becomes decreases. Why resistance becomes decreases? Because number of electron per unit volume and resistance both are reciprocal to each other. At the same manner, resistivity also decreases. Clear? Resistivity also decreases. So these are the two factors. This is the factor and this is also a factor. Which factor is more effectable? Okay? Which factor is also dominating in nature? That will be discussed about in that chapter. Okay? Please listen carefully. So, if you assume a conductor, inside the conductor there are more amount of free electrons are there. That means 10 to power 29 number of free electrons are there per unit volume. Okay, if we increase the temperature, then N becomes increases. That means inside the conductor there are huge amount of free electrons are there. Again, if we increase the temperature, again free electrons are more increases per unit volume. That means if we assume, suppose I mean infinite number charge number with a particular given temperature, पुणि आम कौन करवा कि टेम्परेचर को बढ़ेगा जोद्वारा कि आउ कि परिमाण चार्ज को आम एड करवा जो इनफिनिट चार्ज भितर जो कि परिमाण चार्ज को एड कले कौन हम से इनफिनिट ही हम इनफिनिट जिते एड कले इनफिनिट भी कह तार तो सपोज ये गोटे मेटेरियाल ए मेटेरियाल 10^28 नंबर अफ इलेक्ट्रोन अच्छा ऑलरेडी फ्री इलेक्ट्रॉन पर पार्टिकुलर टेम्परेचर जदि हमें टेम्परेचर को रेज करिबा अगेन फ्री इलेक्ट्रॉन रिलीज हबो रिलीज होगा पर भी से 10^28 नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन रे ऐड हबो सतो 10^28/29 नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन व्हिच इज मोर लाइक एज इनफिनाइट इफ यू अज्यूम से इनफिनाइट नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन रे पुणी किछ हमें इलेक्ट्रॉन को ऐड करियो तहन केत हो इनफिनाइट जेहेतु हमें प्रैक्टिकली भाबिबा तो ए दुटा कंडीशन रे ए जो कंडीशन रहिला इनफिनाइट नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन थिला पर इन वॉल्यूम रे जतले हमें टेम्परेचर को इंक्रीज कले अगेन किछ परिमाण रे इलेक्ट्रॉन फ्री इलेक्ट्रॉन जाई ऐड हो तार्थ इनफिनाइट रे किसी परिमाण तार इनफिनाइट तो सेते सिग्निफिकेंट देखो ने कि टेम्परेचर इंक्रीज हेले भी नंबर ऑफ फ्री इलेक्ट्रॉन इंक्रीज हो सत किंतु एफेक्टेबल हो पारना एज कंपेयर टू दिस वन तेणु आम ए फैक्टर को आम डोमिनेटिंग कर सो इट इज एन बिकम्स N is insignificant. Okay. So that type of factor which is more effectable when we increase the temperature, then what will happen? The resistance and resistivity. In conductor case, if we increase the temperature, then resistance becomes increases as well as resistivity of that material becomes increases. Already I have discussed about resistance depends upon what? Length of the conductor, area of cross section. Okay? But volume remains constant. Okay? At a particular given temperature. Resistivity depends upon material, which type of material we have used, and also depends upon temperature. Okay? So this is not more significant. That's why N is insignificant in nature. So we could not consider that type of factor in case of conductor. That's why conductor, if we increase the temperature of a conductor, then the resistance as well as resistivity becomes increases. Please, I repeat that one. This is important. If we increase the effect of temperature inside the conductor, then what will happen? Then resistance as well as resistivity becomes increases. Okay? Are you getting my point? Okay. Please note it. If you plot a graph between resistivity or resistance along y-axis and temperature along x-axis, then the graph is shown below. If you assume a copper coil that behaves as a conductor, ohmic conductor, so resistance along y-axis or resistivity along y-axis along x-axis temperature is there. That's why due to increase of temperature, resistance becomes increases or resistivity becomes increases. So the graph is like that. This is the practically, which is shown in figure. This is practically noted, that graph. Okay? That is per conductor. Here, per conductor, this is the graph. The resistance or resistivity along y-axis, temperature along x-axis. Okay? This is noted. Second thing is, I will erase that now. For semiconductor. You know, conductor means what? Those substance carry current easily inside it. That substance behaves as a conductor. Those substance carry current partially. That is called semiconductor. Already you know that in electronics. So, in semiconductor, which type of material behaves as a pure semiconductor? Like as germanium. And silicon. These are the pure semiconductor. Why pure semiconductor? Those substance whose outermost orbit contain 4 electron, that type of substance behaves as a pure semiconductor. Clear? Then generally, germanium and silicon both are pure semiconductor. Then, if we assume that in semiconductor, if we increase the temperature, then what will happen? Its resistance and resistivity. Clear? Now, I will discuss this one. If you increase the temperature in semiconductor, then relaxation time becomes what? Decreases. Okay? Relaxation time becomes decreases. Because it is one type of material. At a particular given temperature, some free electrons are there. When I increase the temperature, then more amount of free electrons arises so that they collide with each other frequently. So that the relaxation time becomes decreases. That is. Okay. Due to decrease in relaxation time, resistance becomes increases. R becomes, because resistance and relaxation time both are reciprocal to each other. So R becomes increases. Similarly, resistivity is also increases. Sorry, resistance becomes increases and also resistivity becomes increases. So this is the one type of factor. Similarly, if we increase the temperature, then the number of free electron per unit volume becomes increases. Okay. That means in semiconductor, in generally, few free electrons are there. When you increase the temperature, then more amount of electron becomes released from that given atom. Okay. That means in semiconductor, whose free electron quite less than that of in conductor. Okay. So if you increase the temperature, the number of electron per unit volume becomes increases. That's why resistance becomes decreases, resistivity also decreases. Clear? Resistance and N, that is number of electron per unit volume, becomes reciprocal to each other. That means that becomes increases, that becomes decreases. Also similarly, that becomes increases, that becomes decreases. From above two factor, which one is dominating in nature? Now I'll discuss this one. If you assume a semiconductor, you know, doping. Doping is a process in which we have added some impurity, that means that is trivalent or pentavalent impurity. Okay, these are the impurity if we added in a pure semiconductor, then that in a particular process, that process is known as doping. That's why more amount of electron becomes energetic and they becomes released and they jumps from lower orbit to higher orbit, that means valency band to conduction band. Clear? Okay. So in that process, in semiconductor, at a particular given temperature, few amount of electrons are liberated. That means at room temperature. At room temperature, few electrons are liberated. When you supply the thermal energy, that means if you increase the temperature, then more amount of electrons becomes ionized after breaking the covalent bonds. Clear? So electrons per unit volume quite less than that of in conductor as compared to conductor. Clear? So in that case, n means number of electron per unit volume becomes increases. पूर्वरु आमे कंडक्टर देखथिले कोन इनफिनाइट रे एम एड करथिले एबे इनफिनाइट न थिला जति कि इलेक्ट्रॉन मिलथा आमे ताको संख्या रे गुण करथिले ता अर्थ आमे किछि मै द पार्टिकुलर थिंग रे रिप्रेजेंट करि पर फ्लो एति के अमाउंट रो इलेक्ट्रॉन लिबरेट हिच किंतु जतले आमे कंडक्टर देखथिले इनफिनाइट नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन फ्री भाबे क्रिएट हेतो दैट इज 10 टू 29 80, 10 to 29 number of electron create a no thai. That is few amount. Jato na me increase kore le temperature ko, tahere kichhi parimanto electron asi add hile. Tarto suppose 1000 ta purburu thila, ebe keta asla, ab 500 ta asla, tarto 1500 ta dekhi, electron pole asla, gute per unit volume de. Jota ke ame consider kore parila, in semiconductor. So, a case re, n is significant. But due to n is significant, which is more effectable while we consider effect of temperature in semiconductor. Clear? So this factor is more effectable, but that factor is more effectable, but that factor is not effectable. We could not consider that type of factor because that is the priority or majority consideration. Clear? So, in that case, if you increase the temperature, then number of electron per unit volume becomes increases. Due to increase of number of electron per unit volume, their resistivity and resistance become decreases. Resistivity and resistance become increases while increase in temperature. This is the important thing. Resistance and resistivity becomes increases. Decreases. While we increase the temperature, clear? Resistivity and resistance becomes decreases while increasing temperature, clear? By mistakenly, I'll forget this one. Clear? So again, in conductor, if we increase the temperature, resistance and resistivity becomes increases. But in semiconductor, if we increase the temperature, then resistance and resistivity becomes decreases. Please note it. Now, if you plot a graph between temperature along x-axis and resistance or resistivity along y-axis in semiconductor, in that semiconductor, if you plot a graph between resistance or resistivity along y-axis and temperature along x-axis, the graph is shown that. Okay, this is the graph of effect of temperature on resistance or resistivity in semiconductor. Okay, in that case, at a particular given temperature, resistance and resistivity becomes increases. If you increase the temperature at a certain value, then resistance, resistivity becomes decreases. Okay, this is the graph. Note it. Please quickly. Now, third thing is alloys. Alloy, it is made up of conductor. Alloys like is manganin, constantan, and also nichrome. These are the alloys, and that type of material which are used in practical purpose, because it in order to stability the resistance or resistivity. Why? Because if you increase the temperature then resistance and also resistivity become nearly unaffected. Nearly unaffected. If you increase the temperature for a given alloys, then their resistance and also resistivity becomes nearly unaffected. Because why nearly? Because that alloys are made up of conductor, that's why they are nearly unaffected. Jehetu semane conductor semane kichhi na kichhi affected hochundi, kintu ame जेहेतु एलॉय बोली आम कनसीडर करयरली अनएफेक्टेड भाव कम करते तेणु आम आपको कौन करे प्रैक्टिकल पर्पज व्यवहार करे आगू आम पढ़ा इन मीटर ब्रिज पोटेनसीमीटर वी आर यूज इन दैट टाइप ऑफ मटेरियल बिकॉज इट मेंटेन द रेजिस्टेंस एंड ऑल्सो रेजिस्टिविटी इफ यू प्लॉट ए ग्राफ बिटवीन टेम्परेचर अलोंग एक्स एक्सिस एंड रेजिस्टेंस or resistivity along y-axis, the graph is like that. So this is the graph of effect of temperature on resistance or resistivity in alloys. Okay, please note it. So these are the overall view of effect of temperature on resistance or resistivity. If any doubt, then ask me, or I will clear that one. Please like, share, and subscribe my channel. Thank you.